So I just want to begin by asking why climate change is a priority for Costa Rica. You've taken a very progressive role domestically in trying to address the climate crisis.
Yes, well, even though we have to adapt to climate change, that's our biggest priority. We want to work by giving the example to the other countries and become a global laboratory to show the other people that a small country, a developing country, can become carbon neutral by 2021.
And what kinds of actions are you taking to achieve this target?
Well, right now, what I'm presenting here is because we certified the first carbon neutral coffee product in the world. And so we are also working in other sectors. But I think this is a very concrete case of success that something can be done, and we want to project it to other sectors.
And why did you look at the coffee industry specifically? Why is the coffee industry important for Costa Rica?
Well, in fact, they were anxious to do it. They have a 15 years history of doing good things for the environment, lowering their footprint. And so at last, people said to them, well, you can become carbon neutral. That's just something natural. So what I'm saying is that people, producers, even simple people in Costa Rica, understand that climate change is threatening their production. So if they do climate intelligent actions, they can lower their emissions and become more climate resilient.
And you say that climate change is impacting production in Costa Rica. How is climate change impacting coffee production?
Well, right now, for example, 2% of the national coffee production decreases each year due to climate-related events.
And does the production of coffee contribute to climate change as far as Costa Rica's emissions are concerned?
Yes. Agriculture is the second largest greenhouse gas emitters in Costa Rica, and coffee production accounts for 25% of the greenhouse gas emissions from agriculture. So it's an important sector that we're working on.
And how much are you able to reduce these emissions? How big are the steps you're taking?
Well, for example, for this carbon neutral coffee, they reduce their greenhouse gas footprint by 75% in a 15-year period.
And are you optimistic that this is going to be scalable up across the industry in Costa Rica and possibly internationally?
Sure. Well, right now we're here in Durban, really far from Costa Rica, but we have the National Coffee Institute from Costa Rica working with us. People from the producers in Costa Rica, the government is supporting us. So even though I'm young, I have all these people supporting these actions. So we're very optimistic that a NAMA proposal for the coffee sector will be achieved.
And do you think that by showing a lead domestically and by forging ahead, you can set an example internationally? And do you think people will follow you more broadly at these talks?
Yes, I'm confident and I hope so, because there's a lot to be done. And for us young people, I guess, most of the things that are happening right now, the effects of climate change will be even harder if we don't do anything right now. So we need more allies right now to do something and work with us from all around the world.
Thank you so much for speaking to us. It's really interesting.